or down and scroll to whichever tire it is, then hold the set button again till you hear it beep, and then you'll see that one tire flashing. We'll go ahead and do it here. Trucker those pads. We got my wife. We got her a bag for her laptop. Watch this on YouTube, Tourette's Trucker. Of course, it's got 21 Transport, the name of our company. Tourette's Trucker logo, got her name on it. That's pretty cool. And now for something else that we have is cool. Let me show you that. Let's put this down here. I got 10 of these to wear. Whoopsie. Pardon me, y'all. We have shirts with the Tourette's Trucker logo on the left chest and on the back of the shirt. You have us watch us on YouTube. So that's pretty cool. So yeah. I'm pretty excited about this. So, you know, got a little Thor over here. So, you know, I think that's pretty cool. That'll help us promote the channel, you know, when I'm wearing it, I'll wear it at the truck stop. Because if you think about it, okay, I'll put the shirt on. Okay, say I'm standing in line at the truck stop. People standing behind you, someone will see that. They'll read that and say, hey, okay. But now, you know, if we're honest about it, let's think about it. Who actually, I've seen a lot of people, they actually put their channel name on the front of their shirts. But that's only good if you're talking to someone face to face. Me, I'm not really go interact with people. I like to say to myself, I don't handle crowds too well. So for me, the shirt is perfect because every truck driver goes inside a truck stop. They're either in line to get a fuel receipt, or they're in line to get a refill, get something to drink, get something to eat. Walking through the store, or they're walking to the fuel aisle, another truck driver's walking behind you. So to me, my opinion is they'll see that and they'll read that. A name like that'll stick out. So I think that's pretty cool. And if you are wondering, yes, I did just get out the shower. I actually had all this video made earlier, but the microphone, for some reason, wasn't picking up sound. I guess it's the cable that I used. We got a new one microphone and all for my wife to use. And I guess it's not working with this Nikon camera we have at the house. So I have to use the Nikon camera's actual camera microphone. Not with the dead cat and all that, it's not working. But yeah, I'm sporting my good old Yoda pajamas. I got my Nightmare Before Christmas Jack slippers on. I am styling and profiling, and the wife should be home here in a second because I heard the notification that she's in the neighborhood. So we're gonna redo the video to an extent. This whole thing was actually supposed to be an unboxing. I got the Vesafe tire pressure monitoring system. So let's get set up for that and I'll be right back. All right, y'all, pardon, I'm gonna have the birth control glasses on because, you know, I can't see. I'm getting old, you know, I will be 52 in 2 months. So, you know, it is what it is, y'all. But anyway, we have the Vesafe. It was actually in the Amazon box. Then I did the whole video with the unpacking, showing me programming, showing it out there in the car, everything. But I'm not going to redo all of it. So I'm just going to do, you know, some of it. So anyway, this is it, y'all. It's a wire tire pressure monitor. So it actually has 10 sensors in this. Gives you real-time display of tire pressure, which actually filmed part the very end of the video with my cell phone. So that part showing you how it matches up with the Yukon out there, I put them actually four of them centered on the Yukon tires, and we tested it to see how it was. It was only one tire was one pound off on tire pressure. Other than that, the other three were dead on with what the Yukon side tire pressure was. But let's open this up. Let's see. There we go. Okay. Of course, it's already been opened. Already read the directions. Okay. Here is the actual thing. It's small, it's lightweight, it's compact. Of course, I've already got it programmed for my 10 tires. And of course, you know, you don't see the other sensors over here. It accommodates more, but I don't have them here because I've only got 10 of them programmed, and I've already programmed them in here, so this is pretty cool. It comes with in a phone case like this. So turn this on, and here's your 10 sensors. To program these, all you have to do is when you turn it on, you push and you hold the set button. Once you push and hold the set button, then you can push the arrow up or arrow down and scroll to whichever tire it is. Then hold the set button again until you hear it beep, and then you'll see that one tire flashing. We'll go ahead and do it here. Okay, so now you see it. See, now you got this one front tire right here flashing, and it has a code in it. The reason why it's got a code is because it's already programmed with the sensor. So what you do when you push and hold the set, once that starts blinking, all you have to do is move the sensor over here to the left side of it, and it'll actually program this sensor with that tire. Then you can just move on. You'll hit the plus sign, move plus sign here. You'll move to the next tire, hit your next sensor, push it over towards the left side, and program that one. What you do, you just keep moving to each tire, push the set button. Once it beeps, this display here will read all F's all the way across it, meaning that it's blank. So then once you hold the set button and the light starts blinking and you hear a beep again, you just pull this over to it, and then it programs that sensor with it. Now, as you can see on here, maybe you can see, I've got stickers already on them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I've already got the tires numbered. So which ones, I know when I get to my truck tomorrow, I know what sensor goes on which one, which tire. Because you get a sticker plate like this. And of course, you know, it had them on here, but once you pull the stickers off, you don't know which one here. So you have to kind of remember here, but I actually wrote on it. And then I wrote on the back, you know, left side, right side, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I know which sensor goes on which tire. So that's pretty cool. So this is gonna be a good thing to help. So if you think about it, you know, it comes with a suction cup mount for the windshield. So this slides in, slides on. Put this on the windshield. It just slides in. Put that in the windshield. It actually comes with a USB cable with a micro USB that plugs into here. And then you'll just use either a cigarette lighter adapter, which I actually don't have cigarette lighter adapters in my truck, but as what I do have in my truck, I actually have USB outlets in my dash. I bought dual USB outlets in my dash and drilled the hole and actually have those mounted in the dash. So all I have to do is plug USB cables into the dash, because I've already got, you know, plugs, just like light switch plug, toggle plugs, but they're USB plugs. So I can plug these in and use them as my chargers. So that's cool. And of course, you know, it being small and lightweight, you can always take this off and take this inside and hide it. Leave a suction cup on your dash, that way if you're worried about it getting stolen, you don't have to worry about it getting stolen, you can take it with you. It also comes with, which I wouldn't use myself, you got a rubber pad with a mount with screws. So if you want to actually put the rubber mount on your dash and screw it into your dash, which I'm not screwing four holes in my dash to mount this on. I'm good, I don't need to do that. So that I'm not gonna worry about. But that is the option that you do have. It also comes with a wrench. You have a wrench for tightening these on. And you have a bag with your nuts. You've got extra O-rings. So you've got your, okay, here we go. We got a whole complete set. You have the small O-ring here. Of course, a small O-ring goes inside this that screws into your valve stem, or onto the valve stem. So that's one O-ring. The second O-ring actually goes in the top right here. So when you go to have to change the battery out, you use the wrench and you pull onto this and you actually hold the bottom and you turn that, and then you can take the battery out and change the batteries. They're the flat round 2032 batteries that screw in this, and that's what sends the signal. So you've got an extra O-ring for each of them for that, and that keeps it watertight. Now the nut here. The nuts are for when you take your cap off your valve stems. You'll screw this all the way down on it. Then you'll screw this onto your valve stem. Then is what you'll do if this is, you know, of course they'll be kind of separated. So then you'll actually use this wrench and tighten this wrench. Well, say it sits like that on your valve stem. This will come around like this, and that'll link on right there. You see how it's a perfect fit. And then you just spin the nut counterclockwise, and then that tightens this nut back up against this. It helps lock it in, so then that tries to keep people from being able to steal their thing, because it's gonna be tightened down and locked down on this, onto your sensor, so people can't just go and screw your sensors off because you're gonna have a nut tightened down on it to help hold it. Hi, honey.
Hi.
So, I think that's pretty cool. It's a pretty nice set. It's Vesafe. I got it on Amazon for $2.99 on my Amazon business account. I've got an Amazon American Express card, so I get 5%. It's either 3 or 5% cash back on purchases on Amazon using the Amazon American Express card. So that's cool. I got American Express and Amazon American Express, but you know, I don't get the discount with the regular American Express, so I use the Amazon American Express to get the discount.
All right, y'all. I know I'm in different clothes. This is a different day. But since I lost all the stuff I said earlier in the video about the tire pressure monitor system, I'm actually piecing something else together. I'm actually here waiting to be loaded here in Kansas at a salt mine. So, on my tire pressure monitor system, I actually have that installed here on the truck. We're going to let you look at it. Okay. So, we have it here. Come on. Focus. There we go. Now that's somewhat focused. Come on, you can do it. Focus. There we go. As y'all can see here, we got the tire pressure on it. This is the tire pressure, and this is the actual temperature inside the tires. If we can get it to focus and actually see. There we go. Okay. Like, you see that? That's the top, the front right steer, 107 PSI. Now here's the other steer, 108 PSI, 66. Now it's blinking on the other one over there. So you can see that's 103. Then that one's 99. I've been sitting here for about an hour and a half, so the tires are cooling back down. It's only 67 degrees here. 102, 109 on that tire. Outside drive over there, 103. 103 on the inside drive. 103 on that drive. And 102 on that drive. Now once I get going, they're usually pump up because I've got the halos on there that'll build them back up. So on those, they will normally jump up, close up. They will normally get up to about 3 PSI within each other. Build up some pressure. But we will show you what they look like here on the truck. As you can see here, I got it numbered. Come on, you can focus. I don't want to focus too well, but you get the gist of it. There we go. That's the two. Now over here, of course I've got my halos here. Got chrome covers over them. There's the inside drive tire. Here's the outside drive tire. You can see I've got one here, and I've got one here, because on these halos here, which I did a video on my halos, so look at the pure halos video. You'll actually see here's a port here where you can actually check the tire to pressure, or you can add tire pressure to it. But also on the back side here, you'll see another one here. So what I'm doing, you can't check the tire pressure there. For some reason it does not give it, but you can inflate through this way. So what I do if I need to inflate, like when they're cold and been sitting there for weeks and I see something just don't look right, I will take and I'll check it. So look at the system, and then I'll pump it up and add it up. But yeah, so this is what it looks like, y'all, on the halos. So you can have this on here. Halos will keep them pumped up, keep them where they need to be as long as you're running. You know, if you have a slow leak, I did fix some of the leaks, so they're not going down. I just haven't built them all back up. But you know, they'll go down to like 99, and I haven't seen one really go below 99. Like I say, on these, here's the sensor. And got them on both drive axles. So you got your lines, you got your sensor, and if you need to pump it up. But the halos will actually keep your tires pumped up. So that is what they look like here. I mean, they're not too big and bulky. Now if you do want to have to take one off and pump it up, if you don't have halos and it's straight on your valve stem, now you will have an issue if you need to try to get to it tightly on your inside drive in there, because you're not going to be able to reach that sensor, because you actually have to use a special wrench. You see the nut right back in here. You have to use a special wrench that fits around, like I showed you in the beginning of the video, to tighten it down. So, you know, you can't just see, they don't just come off, because you got that backed up on it tight, and there's not enough room to get it on there. So, you know, so that's something to keep in mind. But yeah, these are actually nice. So it'll warn you. Like, actually had it warn me the other day. It was actually like 89 degrees and it was actually hot. I was actually on an asphalt road running. Can't remember where I was at, but the tire pressure actually got up to, what was it, 120 or something, 124, 125. So it gives you 20 PSI over, only 10 PSI under pressure, then it gives you a warning, 20 PSI over. So it actually gave me a warning, like, hey, you know, your freaking tires, you know, getting freaking hot. So luckily, you know, I went out there and I freaking let some air out of it. And I haven't had any problems since. It was just one tire that was building up. So got it fixed, everything's good to go. That is the tire pressure monitor system. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. Hope you got some useful information out of it. Got to think about getting it. It's on Amazon. That's the Vesafe tire pressure monitor system. It's like, I think I got it for like $299 or something like that. Anyway, think about it. It'll save your tires. It'll help you out. Let you know if you're coming into a bad situation, and we'll holler at y'all later. Peace out.
You can't touch this.